we now discuss the solution of a problem from the section analysis. And the problem what we are going to discuss now is from the elementary set theory of analysis. This question has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 16th February 2022, and the problem is from the section B. The problem is, let S be the set consisting of the natural numbers 1, 2, 3, etc., 100, and let A be the set consisting of the numbers 1, 2, etc., 10, and B is the set consisting of the numbers 41, 42, etc., 50. What is the total number of subsets of S which have non-empty intersection with both A and B? And we are given four options. Option 1, 2 power 100 by 2 power 20. Option 2, 100 factorial by 10 factorial 10 factorial. Option 3, 2 power 80 multiplied by 2 power 10 minus 1 whole square. And option 4, 2 power 100 minus 2 into 2 to the power of 10. So we are given S is a set consisting of the natural numbers 1 to 100, and A is the set of numbers consisting of 1 to 10, and B is the set consisting of the numbers 41 to 50. And we have to find the total number of subsets of S, total number of subsets of S which have non-empty intersection with A and B. So that is to be find out. Let's now discuss the solution of the problem in detail. That is our problem. Solution. We have S is the set consisting of the numbers 1 to 100, A the set consisting of the numbers 1 to 10, and the set B consisting of the numbers 41, 42, etc. up to 50. Let capital T be the set of all those subsets of S which have non-empty intersection with both A and B. Therefore, T is the set of all those subsets X of S such that X intersection A is not empty and X intersection B is not empty. Now, take the power set of S minus T. Power set of S minus T. So, from the power set of S, if you subtract minus the set T, then it will be the set of all those subsets X of S such that X intersection A is empty because we have taken minus. So power set of S minus T consists of all those elements which are not there in T. So we have to consider the set of all those subsets which are not there in T, that is all those subsets of S which have empty intersection with A or which have empty intersection with B. Here it is and, we have taken a minus, it becomes R, and that is equal to the set of all those subsets X of S which have empty intersection with A union the set of all those subsets of S which have empty intersection with B. So this R is converted into union. So these are the two sets. So that is, this is precisely, the first one is precisely the set of all those subsets of S minus A. So if you take a typical subset of S minus A, that will have empty intersection with A, because all the elements of A are subtracted from S in S minus A. So in S minus A, we do not have the elements of A. Therefore, S minus A, that subset intersection with A will be empty. So also, it is the power set of S minus B. So that implies, take the number of elements present in that. So the number of elements present in power set of S minus T is equal to number of elements in the power set of S minus A union power set of S minus B. And the number of elements present in power set of S minus T is number of elements present in P of S minus N of T. And here you apply N of X union Y is equal to N of X plus N of Y minus N of A X intersection Y. That formula you use, that is the precisely the principle of inclusion and exclusion, that will give you N of the number of elements present in power set of S minus A plus N of power set of S minus B minus N of power set of S minus A intersection power set of S minus B. Yes. So this is equal to N of power set of S minus A plus N of power set of S minus B, precisely as above. For N of power set of S minus A intersection power set of S minus B, it is N of power set of S minus A union B. That means we have written power set of S minus A intersection power set of S minus B is equal to power set of S minus A union B. This is the step which is very crucial here. And the proof of this I have shown at the end. I will discuss the proof of it at the end of this problem. We continue in the next slide. So far we have seen the power set of S minus N of power set of S minus N of T is equal to N of number of elements present in power set of S minus A plus the number of elements present in power set of S minus B minus the number of elements present in the power set of S minus A union B. And now this is N of power set of S is 2 power N of S minus N of T is equal to N of power set of S minus A is 2 power the number of elements present in S minus A plus 2 power the number of elements present in S minus B minus 2 power the number of elements present in S minus A union B. Let's now see what is S minus A. S is this set, A is this. So S minus A is the set consisting of the elements 1 to 100 and you have to subtract, you have to take out the elements 1 to 10. Then it will be 11, 12 up to 100. These are 90 in number. S minus B is other than this 41, 42, 50 from S will be 1 to 40 and 41 to 50 is not taken. And 51 to 52 up to 100. So how many are these? These are 40 in number and these are 50 in number, these are 90. And S minus A union B. A union B means other than this 1 to 10 and 41, 40 to 50. And that means S minus A union will be 11, 12, that is 1, 2 up to 10 is not there, is not there. And 11, 12 up to 40. And 41, 42, 50 is not there. The remaining 51, 52, 100. These are precisely 11 to 40. These are 30 in number. 51 to 100. And that is 50 in number. The total is 80 in number. So now N of S will be S consisting of 100 elements. Therefore N of S is 100. N of S minus A is 90. N of S minus B is 90. N of S minus A union B is equal to 80, which we have already discussed. And now, this equation 1 will give you 2 power n of s 2 power 100 minus n of t is equal to 2 power n of s minus a 2 power 90 plus 2 power 90 minus for this 2 power 80. So we want n of t, and the number of elements present in t will be 2 power 100 minus 2 times 2 power 90. 2 power 90 plus 2 power 90, 2 times 2 power 90 plus 2 power 80. Now, from this, take 2 power 80 common, then you will get 2 power 20 minus 2 into 2 power 10 plus 1. And this is precisely x square minus 2x plus 1, and this is x minus 1 whole square, where x is 2 power 10. So that is 2 power 80 into 2 power 10 minus 1 whole square. So that is the number of elements present in T. That means the number of subsets of S which have non-empty intersection with both A and B is this answer. Let's look at our options. And our answer, 2 power 80 into 2 power 10 minus 1 whole square, appears against option 3. Therefore, our answer is option 3. So that is a very interesting question from the elementary set theory, from analysis. I'm sure that you have understood the solution of this problem, and go on working out problems of the similar nature. Now, I have already promised you that I will show that the power set of S minus A intersection power set of S minus B is precisely the power set of S minus A union B, the proof I wanted to show. Okay, let's take a tip. X belongs to power set of S minus A intersection power set of S minus B. This will be if and only if X belongs to power set of S minus A and X belongs to the power set of S minus B. This is if and only if X is a subset of S minus A, because X belongs to power set of S minus A, and X is a subset of S minus B. And that is precisely if and only if X is a subset of S minus A intersection S minus B, because it is AND. That means if and only if X is contained in S minus A union B. X is contained in, X is a subset of S minus A union B. Why? Because S minus A intersection S minus B is equal to S minus A union B. This is called De Morgan's law. So for S minus A intersection S minus B, we have written S minus A union B, X is a subset of. So that means therefore, X belongs to the power set of S minus A union B. This is if and only if throughout, therefore they are equal. So the power set of S minus A intersection power set of S minus B is equal to power set of S minus A union B. That's the proof, and this is that result I have used in the counting process. So I thought this is not familiar to many of our students, therefore I have discussed this. So that is the discussion of the solution of the problem. And from the problem is from the elementary set theory. I'm sure that you have understood the solution of this problem, and go on working out some more problems on these lines. I wish you all the best. Thank you.